The human life has become a chaos within. Our emotions, thoughts, feelings, everything is disarrayed. How to put that into the right perspective? One way is through meditations. The other ways and means are there also. But people do not follow their own scriptures. In Ramcharitmanas, in Uttarakhand, the sage Vasishtha comes to Ram. Ram invited all the citizens and the priests and all of them and then gave them this talk. Vasishtha said that the work of the priest is considered in all the scriptures as of the lowest category. He knew about it, so he mentioned it to Brahma. He said, no, you continue it, because it is through this work you will get in connection with the Lord when he incarnates in the same dynasty as the son of Dashrath, and you will encounter that. Then Vasishtha asks him to give him all the that is necessary, to give him the blessing of his association, teachings, all that is necessary. Every religion, every person has his own philosophy. Hindus have their Hindu philosophy, Muslims have their Muslim philosophy, Christians have their own philosophy. Then how can move the chaos and bring harmony within? It is a matter to be pondered about. If you teach the Hindu philosophy to a Christian, there is a resentment. If you teach to Muslim, there is a resentment. How can it be done? In the past, masters did not eat the food cooked by others. They cook their own food and eat that. Because there are so many subtle vibrations that you put into your foods. The ingredients that we use, the gross ingredients that we can see. We can see the oil, we can see the flowers, we can see the vegetables, we can see spices, but we do not see the subtle vibrations. What is your innerness? Is there chaos or there harmony within? If there is harmony within, then that harmony will be going into it. But if there is chaos within you, then you are putting unknowingly your chaos into the food. The food will not be a blessing. So first thing is this, how to bring about, and then you have to have a thorough understanding of all these spices. There are many different emotions when you look into, categorize, can associate the same way as with the spice, different kind of spices. Some are sweet, pungent, salt, bitter, 9 different juices that form the part of human food, forms the part of our inner life. All that are in discern. When you are in the association of the people who listen to you, who are in harmony with you, your whole environment, your whole innerness changes. But the moment you see someone who you do not like, your whole something begins to happen and you get sick within. Sometimes you will find that, you see, I cannot tolerate that person. The moment I see, something turns off in me. This is a state of chaos. If I tell you to do this meditation, no, I am doing that meditation because he is Indian. I am like he. He is a follower of this one and that one. No, I am doing that. What is the alternative do we have? Then I went into the cooking. No Hindu has a controversy with my cooking, no Christian, no Muslim. All of them appreciate the food when it is cooked. And if you have a harmony within yourself, you can put the same harmony into your cooking. Whatever you do, not only in cooking, when your walk is there, your walk will be elegant, harmonious walk. It is a dancing walk. It is a dancing words flowing out of you. It is a dance coming out. It is a song coming out of you. It is you are singing and cooking. You look at the people playing the steel pan, how the joyous they are. They are dancing and playing the music, and the music becomes that captivates the people. So the same thing has to be with your cooking. You put into your innerness. How to associate with the people who are not interested in meditation, or they have their, if you talk to anyone, you say, I have my guru. I have my master. Everybody have their guru, everybody have their masters. and they are satisfied with that, although nothing is changing within. I have to choose a line where I can approach many people who have nothing to do with meditation, nothing to do with religion, but their religion is food, good food. So learn to make the good food in a harmonious way. I have to use this particular field in order to translate those inner harmony, blessing, the trends of meditation into the food. So when you cook the food, food becomes meditation. And then you have a complete understanding of the oils, fats, spices. So you are blending the spices so that the food could be totally of a different quality. It should be fulfilling. It should be bringing about transformation in you. And then the people who eat the food, they will find on the whole, apparently they can say food is tasting totally different. It is tasting out of this world. That is all they can explain. When somebody says it is tasting out of this world, that means they are referring to something which they cannot understand. They are referring to something that relates to the unknown and unknowable. This is the spiritual dimension, the dimension of the beyond. In order to do that, I have to put the cooking into it. This is aspect of applied spirituality. You have understood the innerness, how to balance the inner emotions. Your anger, your hatred, jealousy, love, how to create something which is totally beyond that. Our love is not love alone, it is love and hatred both. The person you love the most, you hate the most also. It goes simultaneously. The person that you like, you dislike the most. The person that is your friend is enemy more. You gain more from your enemies than from your friends. It is said that you have to choose your friends anyways, but you have to choose your enemies very wisely. One who is your friend can stab you one day. So you have to be careful about your friends. And when your enemy dies, something dies in you. So all these things to put together, it was for this reason that I had to put all the spiritual tenets into the field which nobody can deny. There is no controversy. No one says that this television I will not use. I will not use electricity because it is not a Hindu electricity. It is a Christian electricity. The bulb developed by Thomas Alva Edison, a Christian. No one says that. Everybody uses that. There is no controversy about the sunlight. But when you say sun god, then the controversy comes. So you go into that field where there is no controversy, and all that you have learned, you have understood, pour into that. And all those people who have participated in the cooking courses, cooking classes, they will observe, subtly if you analyze, you will find that there is a new dimension added to your relationship, to your friendship, the environment at home. Your relationship with your husband, with children, with friends, everything, although maybe slowly, but is beginning to change in one way or the other. With that there, your inner feelings, your state of health, because when you are holy, when you are total, you are healthy. Health comes from the word, the same root, health and holy. If you are discontinuous within, your emotions are disarrayed, there is a chaos within. No matter how healthy things you eat, you will not attain to health. Because it has to do a lot more with your innerness. This is why two words are there, chaos and cosmos. Cosmos means in existence, everything, nobody is doing it, yet still everything is happening in a synergistic harmony. Nobody is telling the stars when to rise. Nobody tells the flower, the sun has risen to blossom. Nobody tells the birds that the sun has risen. It is a dawn, it starts chirping. This is why it is called cosmos. And when that begins to happen, you are dancing like a bird. Somebody comes in, you are ready to do anything to share your being. When you are sharing your food, you are sharing your being with the people. You are sharing your joy, you are sharing your innerness. And then when you are cooking your food and you have understanding of all the spices and the ingredients, whether it is fats, whether it is the what kind of all these things you are using, then it will begin to bring about a change in you and in the other also. We try to bring the change in the other and think verbally that it will happen. But it is through your own actions. Food is action. You are bringing something which I give you the packet of Rajagira flour. What am I going to do with it? I know nothing about it. Other flowers, when all these flowers put together and you put your being into it and your understanding about the cooking, understanding about the ingredient, you create something. It is a creation. I do not know whether God is creator or not, but a God is embedded into his creation. So you are creating something. You have become a creator. A dish is created. It has the all the taste that is needed into it. Why you put a little chili pepper into the sweetness? It enhances the sweetness that is there. A little, one piece of chili in the sweet items, but you have to incorporate, blend it in such a way that it enhances. Otherwise, you do not know how to do it, then you will not be able to do. So what you are doing, you are learning the intricacies of this, and through that your brain is becoming very active, your whole insight into the items, and with that indirectly you are entering, your insight is coming into your life and living. This is the reason that I went into the food, and it relates to my profession, because the for my source of living I have to do something so that I am not dependent on anyone for handouts or anything there, make my own living. And then along with that, I am sharing with the people all that is there. It is applied spirituality being shared with every action. Then your walk will be different. This is why we have a word called Buddha walk. When you see people going on the street, and now we have the mobiles with the headphones and the devices, you see the person as if going on talking like a mad person unto himself. There is an inner dialogue goes on. All this noise of the mind needs to come to an end. When you cook the food with that hum, you are not thinking, you are putting your joy, you're putting it into your meditativeness, your understanding. Cooking lovingly, cooking meditatively is the slogan that I introduced. Cooking lovingly, cooking meditative. And then this follows cooking for Buddhas. This is added to that, they are cooking for Buddhas. Gap, dot, 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 and then cooking for Buddhas. First you learn and then cooking for who? Then you will not be differentiating between your neighbors, you are not, and you are not cooking to show off anything. Your food, your action is being offered to something which is invisible in you. When you see the light, are you really seeing the light? No. You are seeing the reflected light. This light that you are seeing is not the light that we, the spirituality or the masters talk about. This is reflection of the light. You are reflection of that which is not visible to you. You have to allow that invisible to reflect through your thoughts, through your actions, through your feelings, through your entire life, every aspect of you. So what you are reflecting, the glory of the sun, glory of that supreme being that we call whatever by the name, that is unknown and unknowable, it is reflecting through you. Right now, who reflects through you? In your chaos, it is the undivine. In our common language, we say devil reflects through you. Let the godliness reflect through your actions. Food is your action. When it becomes a meditation, a totally different dish is created. Go into the cooking in that way. And this is the reason that I have chosen the cooking classes. Worry about the ingredients, whatever it is necessary, I put in. Whatever it is necessary, it does not matter how expensive these are. When you look at the cost of the ingredients used in a particular dish, and when we look into the cost that is being asked for, there is no correlation between the two. It is sharing so that the people will learn. I am not losing in any way when it comes to monetarily. The gain is much more than the loss of the money in the use of the ingredients. That should be the concern. And when you are sharing in that way, you gain manifold. You cannot count the blessings that comes to you, the joy that comes to you, that is unto itself a fulfillment that we should look for within ourselves.